Guys, welcome to my channel. At this time, I would like to review this tool. As you can see, this is a deflection indicator tools with the name is Prisma DI, and the type is Prisma DI 5. So what is inside of the box? Are you curious? Let's check together. Come on. Let's reopen the box. What is inside? You can see this is the main component, main instrument. Also, there is three pieces of extension bar. Yeah, two pieces with the length with 160 millimeter. And then one piece is you can disassemble. See, this one I think about 40 millimeter, and this one is about 20 millimeter, and this one about 80 millimeter. And then also you have the instruction manual. Also, this one is grease. Yeah, you can see. You can open this. What's in it? Oh, it's not grease. This is the tip. Transducer tip. There is various transducer tip. So, in other side, you can see the locking device. You can open. So what is inside? So there is the adapter for charging the battery or the equipment. 4.2 volt DC. 1.3 ampere. And then what is next? So this one is cable for transducer, and this one is transducer. Okay, check the this one is transducer, one complete transducer. So on this side is fine adjustment thread. You can see this is the thread is fine thread, very fine. So you can make a proper adjustment with this one. And this one is locking ring. After you are making the fine adjustment, and then lock the fine adjustment thread, so it will not move. And then here is this connecting for cable connector. And this one is a transducer tip. You can see transducer tip. There is a kind of spring inside, so when you are pushing this tip, it have a tension. It will make this transducer fit to the crank web. Okay, and then this one a cable. The cable, there is two port. One port is for transducer, one port is to the instrument. And this cable equipped with I think this one is magnet. Yeah, this magnet is to prevent from dropping of the transducer when we are fit this transducer to the crank web for measurement of crank web deflection. Then we are fit this magnet to the crank web, so it will prevent this transducer for dropping to the sump tank. Then how to fit this one to the cable? Okay, you can check that there is a pin there, so just insert carefully. Then fit the thread. It's like this. And then okay, and then select the length of the web, the gap between crank web. We can measure first, and then we can use this extension bar. Okay, if you have already find how many centimeter of the crank web gap, so you fit this extension bar. Okay, we leave this one. And then what about this main instrument? There is 1, 2, 3, 4 button. One is power button, reset button, and then zero button and light button, and also the display in millimeter. And then the other side, you can find that there is transducer port and battery charging port. How to use this instrument? Yeah, after you ensure that the cable is properly connected, then you select the proper extension bar and then connect the port to the transducer port, then secure the bolt to prevent from detaching. Then power on, push the power button and hold shortly, and then check the battery level. You can see the battery level. When the battery level symbol is show up, it means that the battery is under good condition. When the battery is level is low, so charge this instrument with the adapter for charging battery. Then push the light button if needed. Of course, if you are using this light button continuously, it will consume the battery, but if not necessary, just switch off. After push the reset button, you fit this transducer to the crank web. Yeah, in the punch mark. Usually, in the crank web, there is a marking. This is special for fitting this transducer. So every cylinder having the same. So don't worry. So always the same place to be fit this transducer. And then after that, you can rotate this fine adjustment to make zero. When you turn this clockwise, this value will be increased because this will extend. When you turn counterclockwise, this value will be lowering because this is reducing the length of this transducer. The value is between minus 0.5 to plus 0.5, but much more better if 0.001, 0.0, anyway, this is fine adjustment. You can make the very fine adjustment for using this bolt. After you find the fine adjustment and the value is zero, then you just push this zero button and it will zero automatically. And then don't forget to lock this lock ring to prevent the moving of the transducer from the crank web. Okay, and then you can start to measure the crank web. Okay, anyway, on this display, this is display is in millimeter. Normally that during crank web measurement, the value about 0.00 something or 0.01 or 1 per 100 or 1 per 1000. But during writing on the record, when the value is 0.01 or 1 per 100, you have to write in value 1. Anyway, please check my other video regarding of the using of this Prisma DI5 for measuring the crankwork deflection. Okay, so anyway, using this equipment, this instrument Prisma DI, is very helpful, because when we are using like a dial indicator like this one, when the position is downward, it's not easy to read this value. We have to use mirror lamp. Also, we need to go inside and etc. So using this Prisma or any digital equipment for measuring crankwork deflection is much more helpful, saving time. Also, very easy to operate this one. I recommend this kind of equipment to use for crankwork deflection in any engine, rather than using dial gates. Okay, so thank you for watching my video. See you next time with another review or another information. If you like this video, don't forget to click the subscribe, press the like button, and see you.